In today's interconnected world, it's increasingly difficult to maintain complete privacy. From the moment you step onto a plane to the calls you make on your smartphone, you are being tracked in ways you might not even realize. Welcome to War India News Hour. There are growing concerns over digital surveillance in modern society. With advancements in technology, governments, corporations, and malicious actors are increasingly capable of tracking individuals' movements, communications, and online activities. The common surveillance methods are flight tracking. Airlines and government agencies track the location and movements of aircraft, including passenger information. Phone tracking. Your smartphone's GPS, cellular data, and Wi-Fi connections can be used to track your location and movements. Surveillance cameras. Cameras are ubiquitous in public spaces, capturing footage of people and their activities. Online tracking. Websites and apps collect data about your browsing habits, search history, and online purchases. The implications of surveillance are privacy concerns. Mass surveillance raises serious concerns about privacy and civil liberties. Government oversight. The power to track individuals can be abused by governments or other entities. Corporate data collection. Companies collect vast amounts of personal data to target advertisements and personalized services. This raises significant privacy issues, sparking debates about the balance between security convenience and personal freedom in today's interconnected world. The new Digital Personal Data Protection (DPDP) Act is set to significantly tighten the regulations surrounding the handling of personally identifiable information. Legal experts believe that this will bring much-needed accountability and control over how data is managed and shared. The Act introduces penalties for violators, compelling data fiduciaries to be more cautious when managing and sharing personal data, both within their systems and with third parties. This includes ensuring that any consent given is specific and not used for unrelated purposes. As per experts, the legislation imposes strict limitations on how long data can be stored. The purposes for which it can be used, and the reasonability fiduciaries bear for misuse of data without explicit consent from the individuals concerned. These provisions aim to protect personal data from unauthorized access and exploitation, ensuring greater data privacy for citizens. Let's look into today's headlines. Zoho presents AI-powered improved version of Zoho Analytics. A new edition of Zoho Analytics, the company's self-service BI and analytics tool, has been released. In addition to more than 100 additional improvements, Zoho Analytics has created potent new AI and ML features that allow for automated report generation, predictive analysis, diagnostic insights, and dashboard creation. System memory is converted to video RAM via AMD's variable graphics memory. For its AI 300 Strix Point laptops, AMD has introduced Variable Graphics Memory, VGM, which enables customers to allocate up to 75% of system memory for video RAM. This function provides a seamless upgrade by increasing graphics performance with the Adrenaline app without requiring complicated BIOS adjustments. 8GB of VRAM can now be easily installed on a 32GB laptop. Lenders may designate MTNL as a non-performing asset. Banks have not been kind to Mahanagar Telephone Nigam Limited MTNL, which has fallen behind on loan payments and is now requesting a large cut from state-owned lenders. For the majority of its lenders, the MTNL account is anticipated to fall into the non-performing asset NPA category in the July to September quarter due to the past due loan repayment. Pixel becomes becomes the first Indian space company to secure NASA's order. As part of NASA's commercial SmallSat data collecting program, Bengaluru-based Pixel has secured a record $476 million deal. Since the space sector opened to private enterprises in 2020, this deal represents a significant milestone for the space technology startup as it is the first of its kind for an Indian startup. Interestingly, the agreement is valid until November 2028. Microsoft 365 services down for thousands of users on Thursday. Microsoft's suite of productivity software was reportedly down for thousands of users. The Windows parent company said in a post on X that it is investigating the issue where users may be unable to access multiple Microsoft 365 services. There were more than 20,000 incidents of people reporting issues with Microsoft 365. This comes nearly 2 months after a faulty software update from CrowdStrike affected nearly 8.5 million Windows devices. That's all for now. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to VAR India Magazine. You can download the VAR India app from Google Play Store and Apple App Store for more news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.